Get your game on, everybody. I'm Deuce with Deuce Gaming, and welcome back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist GX Series Walkthrough Part 3. And that is a mouthful, not as much as original series, but you know how it is. If you're hearing a chair in the background, that's because of that. And I'm extremely hyper, because in the last video, as I explained, and I'm recording like 4 episodes all in one, so bear with me. I drank 2 liters of Mountain Dew, so I'm extremely hyper. So don't judge. Anyways, next one's Jaden Yuki versus a mysterious Shadow Man, the Shadow Duelist. So let's get right into it, shall we? Jaden and his friends, Cyrus and Chumley, were wandering the school grounds when they came across an old abandoned dorm that was supposedly haunted. To their surprise, Alexis was also there.
Alexis, what are you doing here? That's funny, I was about to ask you guys the same thing.
We heard about the dorm and wanted to check it out.
Well, that's not very intelligent. Don't you know that kids have a way of disappearing around here?
That's just an urban myth.
No, it's not. Believe me. I know. Why else would the Academy make it a place completely forbidden? If they catch you here, they'll expel you, Jaden.
So why are you here?
One of the kids who disappeared here was my brother.
If Alexis's brother really disappeared, then the rumors aren't just rumors. I say we go back, Jaden.
Yeah? I say we go in.
What? Aw, wait up!
I hope Jaden knows what he's doing.
Ah, who are you?
When Jaden and his friends entered the dorm to investigate, Alexis was captured by Titan, a notorious hitman hired by Dr. Crowler to kick Jaden out of the academy. Titan trapped Alexis in a coffin, using her as bait to goad Jaden into a duel.
Hand over Alexis right now or you'll be sorry.
Excuse me, guys.
The only way I'll free her is if you beat me at a shadow game.
Why does he have the veins? That doesn't come till like way later. Anyways,
I'm not afraid of dueling you, but shadow games don't exist.
The others didn't believe in shadow games either, but they were soon convinced. For you see, when you lose in a shadow game, you don't just pay with your life points, you pay with your soul.
So you're the one behind all those disappearances? Well, you're not getting us, especially Alexis.
Unless you win, she's mine forever, as will you be.
Alright, get your game on!
So I will be using my starter deck again. I could use a story mode deck, but I don't want to. Because I want to use my Elemental Hero deck. I mean, this isn't like my legitimate Elemental Hero deck that I actually like to use. But this is the next best thing to try to stay canon with the story. I can tweak it, edit and stuff, and I really should have. But I chose not to. Because I'm a doofus. Anyways, we're going to quickly activate Future Fusion. We're going to quickly summon Plasma Vice. Alright, so Plasma Vice. And then we have to send this to the graveyard and this to the graveyard. Don't judge, guys. Alright, I'm going to set Mirror Force face down. And then we're going to summon Elemental Hero Sparkman in attack mode. And then we're going to end our turn.
Your move, Titan!
Mystical Space Typhoon, of course. Of fucking course. And then he activates Pandemonium, Archfiend Emperor, Batman. You douche. Mirror Force, you're badass. And he gets to draw another card, and it's Terror King Archfiend.
God damn it.
Alright, my draw. We're going to summon Elemental Hero Heat in attack mode. We're going to attack phase and have Heat attack him directly. And more than likely, we're going to lose our Heat. Draws his card. Terraforming to add another pendulum. Archfiend. Palabyrinth. That's weird. I would have assumed he was going to summon... You know, I'm not going to look a gift horse in the mouth. So right now, I'm going to summon Bursinatrix into attack mode. I'm probably playing really dumb right now, but you know what? I don't care. So we're going to have Heat attack space on, which is Deathrook Archfiend, and have Bursinatrix attack him directly, which he wants that Deathrook in the graveyard so he can summon... excuse me again. Goddamn. Drinking those Mountain Dews was slightly a mistake, guys. Anyway, he draws his card, sets the monster face down. I'm about to burp again. excuse me. Now I'm going to draw my card. Alright, it's E-Emergency Call. So we're going to activate E-Emergency Call so we can add Avion to our hand. Alright, so we're not going to act summon Avion at all right now. We're actually going to set Clayman face down for right now. We're going to go into attack phase and have Heat attack face down again, which is probably another... Oh, wow. It's only Dark Bishop. Alright, so we're going to have Bersinatrix attack him directly. Another 1200 loss. We're going to end our turn. Now, I'm surprised he hasn't summoned Terror King Archfiend yet. Like, seriously, I'm really that surprised. Alright, he's going to end his turn. It's my turn. I'm going to draw my card after he sets a monster face down. Alright, so we're going to activate Oversoul. Alright, Oversoul lets us normal summon a special summon an elemental hero that's normal from our graveyard. Alright, so that's that. And then we're going to summon elemental hero Avion into attack mode, right? Then we're going to go into attack phase. And we're going to have elemental hero Heat attack his Terror King Archfiend that was in defense mode. Then we're going to have elemental hero Avion attack him directly. Sorry, guys, if I'm talking too fast, but we're going to have elemental hero Bersinatrix.
Yeah, Bersinatrix attack him directly. Then we're going to have Sparkman attack him. God!
Anyways, there you go.
No! Jayden was able to defeat Titan and free Alexis from her coffin. Good morning, Sleepyhead.
Where am I? What are you doing here? Hold on, what kind of thank you is that?
We're here because we had to go fight the bad guy, win the duel, and rescue the damsel in distress.
Oh yeah, that strange man snatched me.
That's right, we found your card, and this.
Picture of my brother? This is the first trace of him I've seen in a long time.
I brought it to let you know that we want to help you find him. After all, we can't let you keep...
Yeah.
We can't have you getting locked up in any more tomb searching for him all by yourself.
You were really worried about me, weren't you? Blush.
Alright, so guys, that's that one. We got some Archfiend cards, which honestly are kind of badass, but a pain in the butt at the same time. I know this one wasn't that... long, and these episodes aren't normally as long as like the farther we get into this, if you actually look at the original series, if you haven't already watched it, the parts are really short, and then they tend to get longer and longer and longer and longer because the duels get more complicated, they get harder, and everything else. So anyway, guys, I'm actually going to use the story mode deck for this because Zane, who's on the left, is a badass, and I love his deck. Cyber Dragons is my fifth favorite deck. Anyway, guys, I'm Deuce with Deuce Gaming. I'll see you guys next time. Please like and subscribe down below. Comment down below for any games you might want to see in the future. You might want to... any tips on how to improve my videos or my channel. I'm really willing to learn. I seriously am. I'm all ears, guys. Like, seriously. Anyways. And what else? Yeah, that's about it. So may the heart of the cards be with you guys. And I'll see y'all next time.
Peace!